Okay, good morning YouTube. Time for another post bag. Look at this package first. This one came from, I think it was Amazon, Crazy Deals, an Amazon seller. This is, it's one of their S3500 series is the Enterprise version of their solid state disk, and this is a 300 gigabyte version, and I've got two of those, and I need some place to put them, so I'll show you what is in the other box.
Yeah, the Intel Speed Demon. I hadn't seen that logo before. And this one came from B&H Photo in New York. So that is Synology. See that here? It's a DX213. And I'd showed you an earlier video. I added a disk drive to my Synology network attached storage or NAS device. Is, if we can zoom in on that there, it's basically a two disk expansion box for the series that I have, and then in the back it has a DC input. It uses an external 12 volt power supply. Yeah, and then it's got an eSATA connection that you plug into your main Synology NAS device, and this is one of the expansion bays. You can have up to two of these. You can either have this is a two bay, you can also get a five bay, but the idea is I can have a SSD cache set up on the Diskstation drive array that I have. With one drive, you can do what's called a read cache. If you do two SSDs, you can then do a read and a write cache. So what that does is it puts everything that goes in and out of the disk station is written on one drive, and they actually set both drives up in a RAID 0, which I think is the mirroring. Two identical drives in a box, and since I only have one slot left in my main box, I picked up this little one, and since this has a DC power supply, I may be able to power this off of my solar batteries. This only takes about 20 watts. I'll measure the power consumption. If that's the case, I can power this pretty easily. That's less than 2 amps of DC power, and so that'll basically be like an UPS uninterruptible power supply. This guy off of solar power, if these drives can handle a lot of the frequently accessed files on the system, the drives in the main disk station can then be put to sleep, and when they power down, that'll save about 10 watts on every drive. So you could, right now it's using about 60 watts, and if they're all in hibernation, I think it drops down to 20 watts. So that's my plan. I'll show you a little later how I plan to get these inside of here, and we'll walk through the configuration process. Let's see, we got power cord, power supply, DC output, 12 volts, It says 12 volt 6 amp, but I think this actual unit is specified to only take about 20 watts. So these drives are, let's see, 12 at 0.6, 5 at 1 amp, so that's about 7. So they're, I think these use around 10 watts a piece. Ultimately, I will replace this unit with a little DC to DC power adapter and run this whole thing instead of off of this cord. I'll run it off of a little coax power connector like that and run this off of solar, and then hopefully this will let my big disk drive array go to sleep. So I'll update you when I get a chance to look at that.